Hey everyone, Mrs. Bodishan here. So today we're going to talk all about the transformation of energy. So we need to start off with the law of conservation of energy, which just states that energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transformed. So we're just going from one form of energy into another form. So let's look at some examples together. Our first example is chemical to mechanical energy. So we have me drinking a milkshake. This milkshake is definitely chemical energy for my body. Now, once that has all been drank, I can turn that chemical energy into mechanical energy. The example that I'm giving you is jumping rope. So I can go and I can jump rope, which is that mechanical energy, right? In the form that comes from kinetic energy. So that is definitely an energy transformation. I didn't create it. I didn't destroy it. I just simply transformed it from chemical to mechanical. Next example is going to be a stove. So if you have a stove that plugs into the wall, that does receive electrical energy. So you are taking that electrical energy, once you turn it on and the burner starts to get hot, you are converting it or transforming it into thermal energy, otherwise known as heat energy. Another example, chemical to radiant. So if you were to take a battery is definitely going to be that chemical potential stored energy. And we can put it in lots of different things. One example here is a flashlight. If we were to put that battery, that's chemical energy, into the flashlight, we can turn it on and it will give us light energy. So we can call that radiant energy. You can also call it electromagnetic energy. It all is the same thing. And another example is going to be radiant energy, or electromagnetic light energy from the sunshine. The sunshine will beam down and hit all the plants and flowers, and those plants and flowers will absorb it and change it into chemical energy in the form of photosynthesis. In other words, that's what it eats, right? So that's a great example of that. And then this one is classic on tests and quizzes, so I wanted to bring it to your attention and make sure you understand it, because this is just not one energy transformation taking place. This is several in a row. And this is going to be what occurs at a nuclear power plant, okay? So bear with me as we go through this. So we start in our nuclear power plant with fission. And if you remember back, fission is where we take a large nuclei and we split it into two smaller nuclei. Now, when that happens, we release a lot of thermal energy in the form of heat, okay? So we're transforming from nuclear to thermal already. What we do with that thermal energy is we heat up water and we make steam, okay? The steam will actually turn a turbine, and that turning of the turbine is mechanical energy. So we're going from that heat energy, the thermal energy, to the mechanical energy to turn and spin that turbine. And that turbine is hooked up to a generator, and that generator will generate or produce electrical energy from that motion of mechanical energy. So now we're going from mechanical energy to electrical energy that we can use in our homes and schools. Hopefully this is helpful to you guys. Thanks. All right, guys. So I hope that was helpful to you. Go ahead and check out my other videos that are on energy transformation, especially with potential and kinetic energy, or check out the different forms of energy if you're still having difficulty understanding the difference between them. Thanks. Go ahead and like and subscribe. Bye, guys.